Okay. Thank you very much for having us here and thank you for the invitation. My name is Ansgar Kadura. I'm the co-founder and COO of Wingcopter, and I want to discuss a little bit about our technology and the applications, and especially about transportation that we already did here. So first, we are a drone company that is combining the best of two systems. So we can vertically take off and then fly forward like a fixed-wing drone to have a very convenient use and a long range and high efficiency. So we do that by our patented tilt rotor mechanism that allows us to vertically take off, then swivel the tilt the rotors to forward flight, and that makes it very efficient. So we are a German drone manufacturer with a hybrid drone as a platform. We have multiple applications, and our vision is that every person's life will be positively impacted by the use of drones. So let's go into some examples. If you have a look at search and rescue applications, imagine an accident happening 30 kilometers away, and you can fly there with 150 kilometers per hour. The drone can provide live data, a live video, that can help the authorities to send the right people. Large area survey applications. If you have, for example, in the land management, large maps can help you a lot. But also in agriculture applications, you can fly, for example, with multispectral cameras that can give a lot of valuable information on the crop health, on to help making agriculture more efficient. But today we want to talk more about our transport applications. We've already been here in Mwanza for 6 months and tested our technology and together with a lot of partners. So the challenge we faced was delivering medication from medical stores department in Mwanza to Ukerewe Island. By traditional means of transportation, this takes 4 to 6 hours. With a drone, you can really address these emergency deliveries. So what we were doing is taking off at the medical stores department in Mwanza, putting in the right medication that is ordered, then taking off, flying forward, and after 40 minutes, we are able to deliver the goods to the doctors in Mwanza, in Nansio District Hospital. So that's a huge improvement, 4 hours cut down to 40 minutes. But at the same time, when delivering medication, the doctors there can take their lab samples, put them in an insulation box, and then put them into the drone to fly to Bugando Medical Center. And that's a long flight over the lake, 40 minutes, to reach out to the laboratories in Bugando Medical Center, which have so that's what the project is all about, giving the people access to medication and access to the laboratory samples, to laboratory, high-level laboratory equipment. And we had a great time being here, and a big support from the local government, the Mwanza region, DTBI as our local partner, and also from international partners. So in 2018, we were flying from Mwanza to Ukerewe Island. But what we want to do is we want to think bigger. We want to test more flying from Mwanza to Ukerewe Island and then have a drone port in Nansio to deliver all of Ukerewe District. There are 400,000 people, 36 health facilities on Ukerewe District, and we want to go beyond that. We think about same-day transportation across the lake zone. If you imagine some very specific medication needed in Bukoba, with just 3 drone ports in between, you could transport it within 4 hours from Mwanza. So, we want to use these drone ports then to deliver medication in their radius. And the vision for 2020, what we believe is possible, is a same-day access to all health facilities in the Tanzanian lake zone. So that's something that we would like to work on together with you, and to think the Lake Victoria Challenge big and to make it happen. So, we hope this picture that we'll just show up now won't be just a nice postcard from Mwanza, but also some everyday experience for the people here in Mwanza. And let's create the future together rather than waiting for it. Thank you.